Heavenly Father, Yahweh, you sent your Son to redeem those who were under the covenant of the First Testament. By means of him, Heavenly Father, we have redemption. We have remission of sins. Thank you, Heavenly Father, Yahweh. Thank you. Teach us how to be obedient unto you, for we know that there is no more sacrifice for sins if we willfully disobey. Father, let thy will be done. Let thy kingdom come. Come see about your people, Heavenly Father, Yahweh. It is in the name of your Son, Yahweh Shai, we pray. Hallelujah. Shalom, Israel. Our Lord, Yahweh Shai, is the mediator. He is the go-between for a better covenant. By means of his death, He redeemed those who were under the law, that were under the first testament, that they which are called might receive the promise of eternal salvation. By means of his blood, we can stand before Yah perfectly. This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, verse 1. For the law, having a shadow of good things to come, and not the very image of the things, can never, with those sacrifices which they offered year by year, continually make the comers thereunto perfect. For the law. We are speaking of the law with those sacrifices. We are speaking, Israel, of the law of sacrifice. There are many different categories of laws. We have moral laws. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not commit adultery. We have civil laws, laws pertaining to loving thy neighbor as thyself, how we relate to the children of Israel. We have ceremonial laws. These are high holy days given to us by the Most High Yah, such as Passover, such as the Shabbat, Shabbat Shalom, Israel. We also have sacrificial laws. Our Heavenly Father is nothing to play with. In the day that you sin, in that very day, ye shall die, our Heavenly Father said. Blood is required to redeem us from our sins. And so therefore, the children of Israel had a system of sacrificial laws to atone for sin. We are speaking here of the law of sacrifice. For the law, having a shadow of good things to come and not the very image of the things, can never, with those sacrifices which they offered year by year continually, make the comers thereunto perfect. The shedding of blood for bulls and goats was just a shadow of what was to come. And they could not make you perfect before Yah, but one is to come. One was to come that can stand before Yah to make you perfect. Verse 2, Hebrews chapter 10, verse 2. For then would they not have ceased to be offered, because that the worshipers once purged should have had no more conscience of sins? But in those sacrifices, there is a remembrance again made of sins every year. For it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sins. The sacrificial law, that system was just a shadow of what was to come. They could not make you perfect. The scripture says it is not possible that the blood of bulls and goats should take away sins. If it could make you perfect, you wouldn't have to continue to do it year by year by year. This is what the scriptures is saying. Verse 5. Wherefore, when he cometh into the world, he saith,
sacrifice and offering thou wouldest not, but a body hast thou prepared me.
When our Lord, Yahawashi, his name means that Yahweh is salvation. When he cometh into the world, he saith, sacrifice and offering thou wouldest not. Our Heavenly Father does not desire the blood of bulls and goats. Those were just a shadow of him to come. He said, but a body thou hast prepared me. Our Lord is a perfect sacrifice, and he can stand before Yah perfectly to atone for your sins. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 6. In burnt offerings and sacrifices for sin, thou hast had no pleasure. Then said I,
lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me to do thy will, O God.
In the blood of bulls and goats, our Heavenly Father, Yahweh, he had no pleasure in those sacrifices. They were just a shadow of what was to come. They prepared you for what was to come. Our Lord Yahawashi said, lo. That expression of lo is to bring to mind something that is amazing. It's like us saying today, whoa. He said, lo, I come in the volume of the book. In Genesis, in Exodus, in Leviticus, in Numbers, in Deuteronomy, all the way to Revelation, it is speaking about our Lord Yahawashi. He is in the Torah, the first five books of the Bible. He is in the prophets. He is in the books of wisdom. He is in the gospels. He comes in all of it. It was him in the beginning, and it shall be him in the end. When those priests and the high priest atoned for your sins, it was a shadow of our Lord who was to come. He said, it is written of me to do thy will, O God. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 8. Above, when he said sacrifice and offering and burnt offerings and offering for sin, thou wouldest not, neither hast pleasure therein, which are offered by the law. Then said he, lo, I come to do thy will, O God. He taketh away the first, that he may establish the second, by the which will we are sanctified through the offering of the body of Yahawashi, Hamashiach, once and for all. Above, in Hebrews chapter 10, verses 1 through 7, that we just read, where he said sacrifice and offerings for sin thou wouldest not, our Lord repeats, I had no pleasure in those things. They could not make you perfect, Israel. They only foreshadowed what was to come. Our Lord said, lo, I come to do thy will, O God. He took away that law of sacrifice and that first covenant to establish the second covenant, where you can go before your Heavenly Father. Now, remember, there was a veil, and only the high priest could go into the most holy place. That system involving the law of sacrifice is no more. Our Lord Yahawashi shed his blood that we may go before Yah. By the which we are sanctified, we are made holy through the offering of the body of Yahawashi, Hamashiach, once and for all. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 11. And every priest standeth daily ministering and offering oftentimes the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins. But this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, sat down on the right hand of God, from henceforth expecting till his enemies be made his footstool. In that old covenant, the priest made atonement for your sins daily. And they could never take away sins, otherwise they would have ceased. Our Lord Yahawashi didn't have to do that. Our Heavenly Father, who sits on his throne in the heavens, sent his Son to shed his blood. And his Son, Yahawashi, willingly came to do thy will, O God, that he may stand before Yah for you. The scripture says that this man offered one sacrifice for sins and sat down on the right hand of God. He shed his blood. He entered right into heaven and sat down at the right hand of your Father. Notice that the scripture said, from henceforth, expecting till his enemies be made his footstool. Our Heavenly Father has enemies, Yisrael. His Son has enemies. You too have enemies. Our Lord Yahawashi, he shed his blood for those who were under the first covenant, that is the children of Israel, to redeem you from your sins. Remember that the angel told Joseph and Miriam that ye shall have a son, and ye shall call his name Yahweh is salvation, and he shall save his people from their sins. The Son of God has enemies, and your Heavenly Father said, sit at my right hand. Once he shed his blood, he said, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies thy footstool. The Son of God did not die for his enemies and for the children of God. The Son of God died to save his children from their enemies. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 14. For by one offering he hath perfected forever them that are sanctified. That word sanctified, Yisrael, means to be holy, by shedding his blood. One time, he has made you perfect. He has redeemed you from your sins. You can go before your Heavenly Father now, Yisrael, without spot, without blemish. You can stand perfectly. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 15. Whereof the Holy Spirit also is a witness to us. For after that, he had said before, this is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their hearts, and in their minds will I write them. The Holy Spirit is a witness of this, Yisrael. Our Heavenly Father is not a man that he could lie. What our Heavenly Father declares comes to pass. He declares the end right from the beginning. The Holy Spirit bears witness to the blood of the Son of God, that you may stand before the Most High perfectly. Our Heavenly Father cannot lie. The Holy Spirit bears witness that the Heavenly Father will make a new covenant with you, Yisrael. Let's go to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 20. We'll start at verse 35. We'll start at verse 33. Ezekiel chapter 20, verse 33.
As I live, saith the Lord God, surely with a mighty hand, and with a stretched out arm, and with fury poured out, will I rule over you. And I will bring you out from the people, and will gather you out of the countries wherein ye are scattered, with a mighty hand, and with a stretched out arm, and with fury poured out. And I will bring you into the wilderness of the people, and there will I plead with you face to face, like as I pleaded with your fathers in the wilderness of the land of Egypt, so will I plead with you, saith the Lord God. And I will cause you to pass under the rod, and I will bring you into the bond of the covenant, and I will purge out from among you the rebels and them that transgress against me. I will bring them forth out of the country where they sojourn, and they shall not enter into the land of Israel, and ye shall know that I am Yahweh.
The Holy Spirit bears witness that your Father will establish a new covenant with you. The prophets saw it, Yisrael. The Holy Spirit bears witness to it. As I live, says your Father, with a mighty hand and with a stretched out arm, I will rule over you. This is a covenant by blood. Your Heavenly Father has promised. The Holy Spirit bears witness that he will bring you out of the countries whither he has scattered you, just as he did for your forefathers in Egypt. He brought them out of the most powerful kingdom on the planet. He destroyed Pharaoh and his armies. He split the Red Sea. They passed through. The Heavenly Father brought them into the wilderness, and the Heavenly Father pleaded with your ancestors face to face. Your Father pleads by fire and by sword. He's going to purge out the rebels. Not all of Israel is Israel. Some of Israel are two-thirds, for the prophet says that two-thirds of the children of Israel shall perish. We understand this. We get that. This is why the scripture says that Yahawashi sat at the right hand of the Father until he makes his enemies his footstool. Some of you love your enemies. Some of you refuse to accept or realize that we have enemies. Your Father said that he's going to cause you to pass under the rod in the wilderness. That rod is his ruling staff. You're going to get in line, Yisrael, and I will bring you into the bond of the covenant. The Holy Spirit bears witness that you will be established in a new covenant with your Heavenly Father. The Son of God has shed his blood that you may go before the Father now. Your Father said, ye shall know that I am Yahweh. Let's go back to the book of Hebrews chapter 10. Let's pick it up at verse 17. And their sins and iniquities will I remember no more. Now where remission of these is, there is no more offering for sin. That word remission means to cancel a debt. Where there is remission, where your debt has been wiped clean, you have a fresh new start. Yahawashi shed his blood so that you may stand before the Most High perfectly. Where there is remission of sins, there is no more offering of sin, because he laid down his life. He shed his perfect blood for you. Let's go to the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 17. Matthew, chapter 5, verse 17.
Think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
Our Lord said, think not that I have come to destroy the law. Don't think that I have come to destroy the law, nor have I come to destroy the prophets. He said, I have not come to destroy anything that the prophets have said, but I have come to fulfill. What did he fulfill? For the law of sacrifice. This is what he fulfilled. Our Lord didn't make it okay. He didn't die so that you can stay in your sins. He didn't die so that you could become a homosexual. He didn't die so that you could be a lesbian. He didn't die so that you could be a murderer, an adulterer, a fornicator. Our Lord did not die so that you could be a thief. Think not that I came to destroy the law or the prophets. There are different categories of laws: dietary laws, moral laws, civil laws, ceremonial laws, sacrificial laws. He said, I didn't come to destroy, but to fulfill. He fulfilled the law of sacrifice by shedding his blood and laying down his life for you, that you may be holy before the Most High Yah. Let's go back to Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 19. Having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Yahawashi, by a new and living way, which he hath consecrated for us through the veil, that is to say, his flesh. And having an high priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart and full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Israel, we can go before the Most High Yah with boldness by the blood of Yahawashi. Imagine if you hit the lottery for $50 million and you took the cash option, where half of your proceeds were taken for taxes rather than the $50 million coming in some form of annuity over time. So they take half of your proceeds. Now you have $25 million sitting in the bank, free and clear. Imagine that you go to purchase a $1 million home, and the realty company wants to know if you can afford it. Imagine the boldness that you would have walking into any bank or any realty company to buy, to say, I want that house. You would be bold knowing that you have $25 million sitting in the bank. We can go before the Heavenly Father with boldness, knowing, having faith in the blood of Yahawashi. We can stand before the Heavenly Father perfectly. The scripture says, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts, which is our minds, sprinkled from an evil consciousness. Our Lord didn't die so that you could stay in your sins. Our bodies must be washed with the pure water. What is the pure water? Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26. The book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 26. That he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word. That word sanctify means to be made holy. We are cleansed and we are made holy. We are washed by the water of the word. It's the application of God's laws that makes you holy, that makes you perfect. Our Lord didn't die so that you could stay in your sins. Whoever told you that is a liar. The devil is a liar and the father of the lie. He was a murderer from the beginning. Our Lord shed his blood so that you could go before Yah and be holy, not to be unholy. There is some conversation out there, Israel, whether or not we should be water baptized or not. Our Lord was baptized by water. I see nothing wrong with it. Just know that water cleanses the body, but the word cleanses the mind. This is what cleanses your mind, which is your heart. We must be washed by this word. You have to get your mind right. Let's go back to Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 23. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering, for he is faithful that promised. And let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to good works, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as ye see the day approaching. Israel, some people, some of us are doctors, some of us are lawyers, some of us are athletes, basketball players, football players. There's nothing wrong with those things. In so long as you put Yah first in all that you do, we must remember that our profession is to serve the Most High Yah. You are his children. He called you. He chose you. No other nation of people. For the whole duty of man, Yisrael, is to serve Yah and to keep his commandments. The scripture says to provoke one another to love and good works and not forsake the gathering of yourselves together. Some of you gather by means of camps. Some of you gather by means of churches. Some of you gather together online as we are doing now, Yisrael. However it works for you, do it. Exhort one another as we are exhorting one another now. Remember that our Lord said that where there are two or more gathered in my name, there I am in the midst. All it takes is two or three. And our Lord Yahawashi is in the midst. We are at church right now. Remember, the scripture says that this is he, speaking of Moshe, who was in the wilderness at the church. There was no other nation of people with Moshe in that wilderness. The Heavenly Father brought the children of Israel out of Egypt. They passed through the Red Sea, and he pleaded with them in the wilderness. That word church means ecclesia, and it is the called out assembly of Israelites. Gather yourselves together. Shabbat Shalom, Israel. We need this encouragement, for that day is fast approaching. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 26. For if we sin willfully, after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, there remaineth no more sacrifice for sins, but a certain fearful looking for of judgment and fiery indignation, which shall devour the adversaries. The Son of God didn't die so that you could stay in your sins. Whoever told you that lied to you, Israel. Give that back to whoever told you that. The scripture says that if you continue to stay in your sins willfully, now that you know, you are held to a higher standard for what you know. Think about a police officer out there breaking into people's houses, or a police officer out there raping women, or a police officer out there selling drugs. You're held to a higher standard now that you know. The Holy Spirit has beared witness with your spirit. If you willfully continue in your sins after having knowledge of the truth, there remains no more sacrifice for the law, for the law, for the law of sacrifice. The Son of God did not destroy the law. He did not destroy the prophets. He fulfilled it. He shed his blood. The shedding of his blood is no more valid unto you if you stay in your sins. We must be holy and stand before Yah perfectly. You can go before the throne now. We can do all things in HaMashiach. The scripture says, if you willfully stay in your sins, this is what you have to look forward to: a certain fearful looking for of judgment and fiery indignation, which shall devour the adversaries. The Heavenly Father has indignation and fiery judgment that is reserved for his enemies, for the Son of God's enemies, for your enemies. And if you continue in sin, then you're going to receive the judgment that is for your adversaries. You can stand by them if you want to. Not all of Israel is Israel. Unfortunately, some of Israel are two-thirds. You're just like your ancestors back in that wilderness. And the Heavenly Father said, I'm going to plead with you face to face and purge out the rebels. Our Heavenly Father said that he's going to plead with you face to face and purge out the rebels. Bye. Hurry up and leave. Go. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 28. He that despised Moshe's law died without mercy under two or three witnesses. Of how much sorer punishment, suppose ye, shall he be thought worthy, who hath trodden underfoot the Son of God, and hath counted the blood of the covenant wherewith he was sanctified an unholy thing, and hath done despite unto the Spirit of grace. For we know him that hath said,
vengeance belongeth unto me, I will recompense, saith the Lord, and again, the Lord shall judge his people. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God.
Under the law of Moshe, our Lord comes in the volume of the book. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, those are the laws of Moshe. It's called the Torah, meaning the law. Our Lord didn't come to do away with it. He shed his blood. He did away with the law of sacrifice. Under those laws of Moses, if you were caught doing something abominable, absolutely disgusting, it was off with your head. Under two or three witnesses, the book of Leviticus chapter 20. Leviticus chapter 20, verse 13. If a man also lie with mankind, as he lieth with a woman, both have committed an abomination. They shall surely be put to death. Their blood shall be upon them. Under the laws of Moshe, by means of two or three witnesses, if you were found to be in a homosexual act, a lesbian act, you were put to death. Both you and your partner, your blood was on your own head. Hebrews chapter 10. How much more sore punishment suppose ye shall he be thought worthy who has trodden underfoot the Son of God and counted the blood of the covenant an unholy thing and have done despite unto the spirit of grace? Under the laws of Moses, you were dead. What do you think your judgment is going to be when you come to know the truth and the Holy Spirit bears witness with your spirit and you turn back? What do you think your judgment is going to be for treating the blood of the covenant like an unholy thing? You treated it as if it was nothing. You can stand before the Heavenly Father now. He has given by his Spirit grace. You can stand before him perfectly. What do you think your judgment is going to be now that you know and you turn back? He that has his hands to the plow and turns back is not fit for the kingdom. Imagine being in a car on a windy road on the freeway going 70 or 80 miles an hour and somebody is driving and they're looking back. That's not a car that I would want to be in, Israel. I want out of that car. You can kill yourself, but you're not going to kill me. Let me, the heavens up, out of here. I don't want to be in a car going down a windy road at 70, 80 miles an hour, and some fool is looking back and driving. No, thank you. Once we come to the knowledge of this word, there is no looking back. This is a covenant by blood. Our Heavenly Father is going to purge the rebels. He's going to plead with you by fire and by sword. And the judgment that is established for his adversaries shall be for those of you who turn back. For it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 32. But call to remembrance the former days, in which after we were illuminated, ye endured a great fight of afflictions, partly whilst ye were made a gazing stock, both by reproaches and afflictions, and partly whilst ye became companions of them that were so used. For ye had compassion of me and my bonds, and took joyfully the spoiling of your goods, knowing in yourselves that ye have in heaven a better and an enduring substance. Remember the former days, Israel, when ye were illuminated. This word gives us light, wisdom, and understanding. Remember your first love. And remember, Israel, the great fight of afflictions that you suffered for coming into the knowledge of the truth. It's going to happen. It's not a matter of if or maybe. It's going to happen. You shall be tested. If any man loves his mother, his father, his son, or his daughter, his wife, more than me, then he is not worthy of me, the scripture says. You're going to be tested. And most times, many times, it comes from those who are closest to you. But not all storms come to destroy you. Some storms come to clear a path for you. Some things do not happen to you. They happen for you. Stand with your Heavenly Father. The scriptures here is describing being made a gazing stock. We all know what has happened to the children of Israel. We are a gazing stock unto the nations. Not only just a gazing stock, do they look at you in wonder and amazement, but also a laughing stock. Even when all that has been taken away from us, just know that these are material things. We have a heavenly hope, and our Father is faithful to his promise. Knowing in yourselves that ye have in heaven a better and an enduring substance. Verse 35, Hebrews chapter 10, verse 35. Cast not away therefore your confidence, which have great recompense of reward. For ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, ye might receive the promise. For yet a little while, and he that shall come will come, and will not tarry. Now the just shall live by faith, but if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. My soul shall have no pleasure in him. But we are not of them who draw back unto perdition, but of them that believe to the saving of the soul. Be patient, Israel, that ye may receive the promise. Our Lord does not tarry. He's not delayed. He sits at the right hand of the Father, waiting on his Father's word. He shall come, and he that shall come and will not tarry. Now the just shall live by faith. The righteous shall live by faith. Faith is knowing, even though it is not yet beheld. I know that the sun is going to rise tomorrow. I don't believe that. I know that. Even though I have not seen it. Faith is the assured expectation of the things that are hoped for. The evident demonstration of reality, though not yet beheld. If any man draws back, treats the blood of the covenant as an unholy thing, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. But we are not of them who draw back unto perdition. Perdition is destruction. We don't draw back, Israel. Those who do draw back, those of you who are driving down a winding freeway at 80 miles an hour, looking back and maintaining that position, you're going to perish. And I'm not going on that ride with you. No man who puts his hands to the plow and looks back is fit for the kingdom of Yah. You are like a dog which returns unto its vomit. But of them that believe to the saving of the soul, the words of your heavenly Father, Israel, are as good as gold. It's better than money in the bank. Keep the faith and receive the promise. This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 10. Shabbat Shalom. Yeah.
Thank you.